Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm pretty much done with the setup, so what do you say we finally are gonna put some turtles in here? Before we actually get started, look at this, the last hatchling Cimarrochiella crassicollis of this year. This one is only 2 days old now, and this is actually from an egg that's from my new female. So I have the first baby from her too, and I still have 3 left at my place from this year. So that's very cool, just something I wanted to share. What is also pretty cool is that my male Maremis nigricans is starting to get that typical red coloration on the throat and the belly, and also a bit in his head. So that means he's close to getting to breeding age. So I think in about a year or two, these will also reproduce. And as a last update, check how big my Black Burmese Mountain Tortoises are getting. This is the Monoria emisfairei, and they are absolutely growing very well. You see the growth lines. Grumpy fellows for sure, don't mind hissing or biting, but yeah, super cool. This one is growing so well, so happy with how they are doing. So soon these will get an upgrade too, and of course I'm gonna post a video about that. But it is time to put some turtles in these setups. I'll just show you what I've done since, as mentioned in the previous video, these are 40 centimeters wide, 60 centimeters deep, 30 centimeters high. The land area is also at 30 centimeters, so I could fill up to here, but I decided to do about 20 centimeters of water for this species for now. There's a ramp for the animals to climb on. I'm just looking for slates to put on there. There's a land area. I was just setting up the land area and noticed I was out of soil, so we'll get a bit in a minute, but that won't matter to the animals too much, and I put up a stone so they can walk in and out. Some floating plants, duckweed. Of course, I like duckweed because it provides a lot of hides for the animal, shaded areas, but it also sticks to everything, so that's a bit of a downside. So I'm looking for replacement. I'm gonna get some more plants. The bottom is all covered with soil. There is some simple pieces of bogwood in there so the animals can hide and climb under there. Very simple setup because these animals are new and I just want to see how they do. There's a heater set to 25 degrees Celsius, and the air temperature here is at least 25 in the whole room, but in here it's a bit higher. It's 32 degrees under that basking spot. These animals do like a higher temperature, and of course also UV light. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Trying out different sponge filters for these setups, and eventually these sponge filters will be set up to one air system all through the room. Now the animals are going to keep in here are these snail-eating turtles, the Malayemis subtringa. Now I've been looking for this species for a while. They actually have not been kept and bred a lot. With the subtringa, a few persons breed with them in Europe, I believe 2 or 3, maybe more, but not too many. The Macrocephala, I only know Stefan Edmar from zookon.at on Instagram who has bred them. Also a wonderful species, so maybe in the future I can be able to get those too, but I'm very happy with these. So they are the genus of Malayemis. There are 2 species, these ones and the Macrocephala. There are some morphological differences, and they also are from a different area, but they do look quite similar also in the care, I believe. Now those ducks you see are just there for identification by the breeder. I made some pictures when I got these animals, and I will make updated picture in the future for my administration. It should be a male and 2 females. And here you can see the difference. There's a difference in the anal scutes, how far they are separated, and also with the length of the tail. Could also be 2 males and 1 female. We'll see. I'm sorry. These turtles are actually found in a lot of the same areas as my Cimarrochiella. So I thought about maybe if I have like a bordering male Cimarrochiella with my females to maybe make a nice habitat setup with these in the Ciboquiela, but these turtles are best to be kept separate. And what is also very important is to keep these animals very warm. When they were imported in the past, a lot, they were actually known to be very fragile. A lot of people could not keep these alive. Turns out they are very receptive to stress. It's best not to keep them together. I have seen people keep them together, but all the breeders I've talked to, the ones that are actually successful breeding them, say keep them separate, especially when they are a few years older. And I actually noticed, I don't know which one it is, but I have one of these already missing some toes and with a small distortion in the shell, probably bit off by a younger occupant when they were still kept together. So yeah, it's pretty uncommon to see captive bred of these. These are from 2019. This person has been breeding them for a while, but there are not a lot of persons breeding them. And next to the fact that they need to be kept quite tropical, and they do bask a lot. There are a lot of videos of people finding them in Thailand, etc. Basking in gardens and temples and parks, etc. But next to that, they actually remind me a lot of the North and Central American mud and musk turtles. Just with that huge head, meant to crush any crustaceans. They are called snail eating turtles, but they will eat a whole lot more. I'm pretty sure they will defend themselves. Yeah, a bit at least, they will show off, of course. But also the shape of their shell, etc. And mostly active on the bottom, looking for all kinds of crustaceans. Again, that short tail. It reminds me a lot of them, but I'm very happy to have these. So let's start putting these in the setups and just see how they respond. Isn't that a charming head, by the way? Just so cool. Macrocephala has a bit of a different pattern on the head, a bit wider. Let's put you. I will slowly lower you in the water. These are supposed to be not the best swimmers, like Ciboquiela, etc. But of course, they still can swim. But do make sure there are plenty of spaces for them to reach the surface. So that's why I have this long ramp, and that's why I have all the wood in the setup. Okay, let's put these others in too, and let's see how they are doing. There it goes. Probably gonna hide in the back. Just to get used to it. Aren't they cool little turtles? Now these are temporary setups. They will get bigger, so they will need bigger setups. But again, I will keep them separate the whole time, unless it's breeding. I do have seen some videos with people keeping them with a lot of fish. Just like the Ciboquiela, they're more crustacean and feeders, snails and shrimp and all that kind of stuff. So they don't really actively hunt for fish unless there's some carrion. So I think eventually I will try to add one or two fish to keep the setups clean. You're going in the water, buddy. I really like these simple ramps. So easy for them to climb on. So this is the one with a different shape of angel's cutes and a bit different tail. So this should be the male. And let's put him there too. This way he notices he's getting in the water, so hopefully he takes a nice big breath. And I can just slowly let him go. I'm so charmed by these. In the quarantine setups, especially one of the supposed females, already got very curious. They are pretty active. Feeding on all different kinds of stuff. I fed them mealworms, the reptile expert turtle food, shrimp, mussel, worms, you name it. They have fed on a varied diet already. Oh, sorry. Of course, they're a bit curious, and now I'm shoving this camera in their faces. Now what I'm going to be most careful with these guys is that I don't see any fungal problems. And again, make sure they are kept nice and warm. So that's why the heaters are in the setups. These are ExoTerra heaters. They are set to a set temperature, 25 degrees. They've also always worked great for me. There's this coil around the electrics just to keep it safe. I have a sandy bottom because in nature these animals do walk around on a sandy bottom or muddy bottom looking for prey. So that way they can dig a bit if they want. This is the one you can see. See, is it focused? There's a bit of a chunk out of the shell, and that's perfectly capable that was another younger turtle. Because a lot of people, even with these territorial species, when they are a bit younger, they're often raised together. But as you can see, with feeding, etc., it can go wrong. I've seen the same with Cecalia or with Pelodiscus. They can be more territorial way faster as people think. Just you get such a cool little hat. Using the ramp the way I hoped they would. Now again, this water is pretty deep compared to the quarantine setup, so they may need to get used to it a bit, but that's why I have that ramp. That's why the wood isn't there, so they have plenty of places to climb on. You just need to figure it out. That just one took a nice big breath. Such a cool turtle. What do you think? Do you like them? I know some people ask about making a video about these. I just had to wait super long. I believe I reserved this like a year ago, but then COVID happened and transport was a little bit different. I wanted to pick them up, but I was not able at the time. So super cool, they are finally here. And I'm glad they are in these setups. I really like the design thus far. Simple but effective. I think the animals will like it too. They can go all the way in the back. They can actually hide underneath the land area. So they have a bit of a cave. So I think this type of setup, maybe a bit bigger, would also be perfect for Cecalia, etc. So I'm really wondering how this will turn out in a bit. And if it works well, after hibernation, I need to build a whole lot more. This one's also all the way in the back over there. Such pretty eyes and pattern on the hat. Super glad they are finally here. Okay, I will just leave them be for now. Just let them explore for a day or two. We'll probably feed them some mussel in a day or two because that's one of the items they really seem to like. So I'm pretty sure if they are used to their new setup, if they are gonna get feeding, it will be with that. Isn't that pretty? Yeah, super cool. Very happy also with the setup I made for them. I think this will work absolutely great. You can also see the difference in cutes a bit. They've quite big shields. These are quite big. This one's quite narrow. And if you look at this one, this is a bit bigger, this is a bit narrow, more even. Could be that happened during incubation. Thank you. They don't have any additional skewed, but they are different to each other. Am I bothering you with the camera? Okay, I will leave you. So that's it for the video about the snail eating turtles. Just a quick update on these new turtles in the collection. Super happy they are finally here. I'm hoping they will settle in well and that the setup works for them. I'm definitely gonna keep an eye on them because they are a little bit more of a fragile species, at least what I've read about and seen. So that's very cool. These are cats have bred, but still, you never know. They have been doing great so far and been eating, etc. But you definitely can see that they are like, what is going on here? Again, a new surroundings, and turtles don't really like change that much, at least not a lot of species. So yeah, super cool. All they will do well. Most of them have taken a big breath and walked around a bit. So I will just leave them alone now. Pick up some more plants for them to hide in between. And yeah, that's gonna be it. So thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think of these incredible new cool turtles. And I hope to see you on the next one. I'm sorry about a bit of a bumpy schedule. I'm just getting acquainted with my new work schedule, etc. But every time I can make a video, I will do that. And I hope you enjoy these. So thank you so much. And goodbye.